वेलकम टू ITLS अकेडमी। आई एम धीरेन्द्र कुमार। टुडे वी डिस्कस द मोस्ट पावरफुल टॉपिक एक्सपोजर एंड डोज रिस्पॉन्स मॉडलिंग फॉर फूड केमिकल रिस्क असेसमेंट। दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। नाउ स्टार्ट। देर आर वेरियस केमिकल प्रेजेंट इन फूड मे पोज पोटेंशियल हेल्थ रिस्क टू कंज्यूमर्स। द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ एक्सेप्टेबल exposure level and the estimation of potential exposure to chemical in food are primary component of food chemical risk assessment. The first comprehensive guideline for performing chemical risk assessment in USA were published in 1983. This is the most important. These guidelines separated the process of risk assessment in four components: hazard identification, dose response evaluation, exposure assessment, risk characterization. There are four components. The basis of contemporary risk assessment approaches for food chemical like pesticide, residue, food additive, naturally occurring toxin, hormones, antibiotic, environmental contamination, and even novel product. This is the most important component. There are various components. They exist in our food. Environmental Protection Agency, EPA जिसको बोलते हैं, Environmental Protection Agency to determine the acceptable of residue of pesticide in food supply. This is the most important. EPA is the most powerful agency. He sophisticated, he identified the chemical exist in our food. If any chemical exists more than level, it means they cause disease, they cause effect, या they develop adverse effect. इन सबको क्या करना, identify करना और उसमें क्या करना, उसके risk को minimize करना, ये आपका जो work होता है, that is known as EPA. साइंटिफिक बेसिस ऑफ इम्प्लीकेशन की बात करते हैं। एक्सपोजर मॉडलिंग, द एस्टिमेशन ऑफ एक्सपोजर टू फूड केमिकल रिक्वायर एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ बोथ द अमाउंट ऑफ केमिकल प्रेजेंट इन फूड एंड अमाउंट ऑफ फूड कंज्यूम। द बेसिक लॉगरिथम फॉर फूड केमिकल एक्सपोज कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई exposure equal to food consumption into residue level. This is important. Deterministic exposure modeling, deterministic approach to predict long term exposure to pesticide in food tend to use more realistic estimation than those approaches predicting short term exposure. The preferred method for calculating chronic exposure is to use a deterministic approach. For the estimation of acute exposure, deterministic approaches are frequently being replaced by probabilistic approaches. This is the most powerful approach. These approaches utilize our current computational capability to combine all of the data in the residue distribution with the food consumption data to develop a distribution of daily exposure. The type of exposure is frequently known as, is also known as Monte Carlo simulation model. This is the most important model. Dose response modeling, after the hazard identification step in risk assessment, a dose response evaluation is performed. This evaluation enables the relationship between the amount of human exposure to the chemical and probability of adverse effect. Dose response model vary based on type of toxicological hazard. Model evaluating the dose response relationship for chemical carcinogen assume that no threshold dose exists and that all level of exposure to carcinogen provide at least some finite mathematical risk. Accurate reference dose. The estimate of dietary risk posed by pesticide residue in food have focused on long-term toxicity and have relate to deterministic method to calculate exposure. Accurate risk assessment using deterministic method may consider the maximum detection residue or maximum allowed residue. In August 1999, the EPA limited the use of the organophosphate insecticide methyl parathionone exposure. The NOAEL was determined from the toxicological study containing a 300-fold difference between the NOAEL dose of 7.5 mg per kg per day and NOAEL dose of 0.25 mg per kg per day, suggesting that the true NOAEL would be anywhere from 0.025 to 7.5 mg per kg per day and was more likely to be closer to the NOAEL, L-O-A-E-L, based on toxicity comparison of methyl parathion with other organophosphate insecticide, many of which are considered to be far more toxic than methyl parathion. Infant child susceptibility, the 70x factor. The most controversial provision of the Food Quality Protection Act, FQPA, is also known as 10x factor, 10 into x factor that require consideration of the penalty greater susceptibility of infant and children to pesticide. For infant, maintaining the 10x factor resulting in exposure 0.415 pg per kg per day at the 99.9 percentile. That was 3.8 times greater than the level of considered acceptable. The FQPA required that risk assessment for pesticide residue be based on all-level information concerning the cumulative effect on infant and children of such residue and other substances that have a common mechanism of toxicity. The current and future implications. Food chemical risk assessment practice are dynamic and evolving. It is a model for dose response and exposure assessment for other food chemical will incorporate the scientific advance developed for pesticide residue in food. This is the most important topic. In next lecture, we discuss economic consequences of foodborne hazard. Thank you. All the best.